If you're like me, you store your files all over the place. A random folder here, an external hard drive, and it can be difficult to keep track of everything. But with Search in Windows 7 and a brand new feature called Libraries, you don't have to. Hi, I'm David Washington, a program manager on the Windows 7 team. And over the next 4 minutes, I'm going to show you how Windows 7 makes finding your files much easier. If you're coming from Windows XP land, then you know how frustrating it can be when you can't find the file that you're looking for. Is it in this folder? Nope, don't see it. How about this one? You could try searching, but searching in XP can be pretty slow. In Windows 7, you get search results about as fast as you can type, and you have access to powerful new tools to narrow down or expand your search with ease. And search gets even better when you're using libraries. Libraries are a new way to organize your files in Windows 7. There are 4 libraries in the left pane: documents, music, pictures, and videos. At first glance, libraries seem a lot like folders. They're a little different, though. Libraries don't actually store your files the way folders do. Instead, they gather files from different locations. So when you're browsing a library, you might be seeing files from a lot of different places. The important thing is that your libraries are where you go to find your files. One nice thing about libraries is that you can easily search several places at once. The Pictures library, for example, points to both the My Pictures folder and the Public Pictures folder, so I can perform one search and find all the matching photos from both locations instantly. It gets even better if I include more folders in the Pictures library. Let me show you how this works. Let's try searching the Documents library. When I search, I'm actually searching across all the locations the Documents library points to. Notice how Windows remembers my previous searches and even highlights the search term in my results so I can quickly find the file that I'm looking for. Now let's try a narrower search using a new feature called Search Filters. I'm looking for a presentation that I gave recently, and I know I changed it about a month ago and it contains the word research, but I can't remember what the file is called. I'll click in the search box, then click the search filter date modified. I'll choose earlier this month. Then I'll type the words research. This might be it. In Windows XP, I'd have to go through the trouble of opening the file to find out if it was the right one. In Windows 7, I can just expand the preview pane to see what's inside. Yep, that's the one. Another way to find what you're looking for is to arrange a library in different ways, like by date. So what if you store your files somewhere outside of your computer, say an external hard drive? I store a lot of my digital photos on this drive, and I'd like to be able to access them as part of my pictures library. All I need to do is go to the folder stored on my drive, then include it in my Pictures library. Just go to the folder, click Include in Library, then click Pictures. Now the library is pointing to 3 locations: the My Pictures folder, the Public Pictures folder, and this new one. The pictures on my computer and the pictures on my external hard drive can now be accessed as a single, easily searchable collection. For more advanced ways to customize library locations, click the Locations button in the Library pane. You can change the order in which the library locations appear, as well as the main folder, or default save location, where you want files to be stored when they are copied or saved to the library. Libraries might take some getting used to, but the nice thing about them is that they help you find your files, whether you understand what's going on behind the scenes or not. Want to learn more? Check out the guide for this video. It has a lot of additional information, including step-by-step instructions so you can explore Windows 7 on your own.